बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। आई एम रज़ा अली मुगैरी, लेक्चरर फिजिक्स, केडी कॉलेज, पलवाके। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिजिक्स फॉर क्लास मैट्रिक। सो दिस वीडियो इज रिलेटेड फॉर ऑल द मैट्रिक स्टूडेंट्स एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर 1 टुडे। होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर लेक्चर। Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So today the topic we are discussing is introduction about physics. So basically the study of physics is comes or start from science. Here we are discussing about the science. What is science? The word science has been obtained from a Latin word scientia, which means to know. Simply, science is defined as the knowledge which obtained through observation and experiments is called science. Now, the science is further divided into two main branches. Number first is called biological science and number second is called physical science. Now, what is biological science is? The biological science is simply defined as the science which deals with the study of living things. All the living things related with the definition of biological science. Now the biological science is further divided into the following branches. Number first is biology, botany, zoology and microbiology. In all these branches we discuss about all the living things. Now what is physical sciences? The physical sciences branch of science which deal with the study of non-living things. So the non-living things study is further divided into physics, chemistry, astronomy and geology. So from here our main focus is about the physics. Now what is physics? The word physics is derived from Greek language word physikos. Here the word physikos means natural. Now what will be the definition of this physics? The physics is branch of physical science. What is the branch of physical science? Because it deals with the study of non-living things. It means that physics is related with non-living things study. Now physics is a branch of physical science which deals with the study of matter and energy. The first thing is matter and second is energy. Also it deals with the interaction between them. Now we are coming towards the word that is a matter. Now what is matter? Matter is simply defined as anything which occupies space and having mass is called matter. So the matter is further divided into three stages. It means that in this world the matter is present in four different stages, but here are the basic three one which we are discussing here. Now number first is a solid state, number second is liquid state, number third is gas state. After that we have a energy. Energy is what? Energy is simply defined as the ability of a body to do some work, or the ability or capacity of a body to perform some task is called energy. Now the energy has two main forms. Number first is a kinetic energy, while number second is a potential energy. As we have already discussed in definition of physics, that physics is related with the study of matter and energy. So matter we have discussed, energy we have discussed. Now what is interaction between them? The interaction is simply when matter and energy combine, they will form a new thing. Let examine. We have an electrical bulb. So what is the work of that electrical bulb is? It will give us, or it provide us lighting. When it provide, when we provide its energy, it means when matter and energy combine, they will form a new thing which is simply called as the interaction between matter and energy. Now we have a branches of science. So the first branch of science is mechanics. Simply, mechanics is defined as a deal with the study of motion of bodies under the action of forces. All the motions of body which are related with force, we discuss all them in a branch of physics which is named as a mechanics. After that, we have electricity. And electricity is defined as the branch of science, physics, which deal with the study of properties of electric charges and their effect. Deals with the study of properties of electric charges and their effect, either the charges at rest or in motion. These will be discussed in electricity. Then we have electromagnetism. This electromagnetism is combined from two main things. Number first is electro and number second is magnetism. This electromagnetism is a branch of physics which deal with the study of laws, principles that are relating with electricity and magnetism. Now we have a solid state physics. And what is solid state physics is, it deal with the study of properties, structure and composition of solid materials. All the solid materials which are existing in this world, they are composed of different structure, different properties and different composition. All these things are discussed in solid state physics. After that, we have atomic physics. This atomic physics is branch of physics which deal with the study of structure and properties of an atom. Then we have nuclear physics, and this nuclear physics is a branch of physics which deal with the study of structure, properties and the reactions which are occurring in nuclei of an atom. Here the term is used as a nuclei. This nuclei is used for the central part of an atom, which is called nucleus. Then we have a very important branch of physics, that is a plasma physics. And this plasma physics is deal with the study of properties of highly ionized atoms. Here the term ionized means ions, and this ion is created when the charges can appear on atom. Simply, the atom is an electrical neutral. Electrical neutral means it has no charge. There is a reason for it, because the number of proton existing in nucleus is equal to the number of electrons that are revolving around. They are equal. Therefore, the charge on atom is neutral. So when an atom loses or gains an electron, then charges appear on it. On the basis of that, if an atom is a highly ionized means it can lose its all electron, then the charge will appear on it. Then it will be in a state of physics which is named as a plasma physics. Then we have a biophysics, and this biophysics is defined as, it deal with the study of applications and physical method that explain the biophysical system and structure. We can simply define this biophysics as the physics which related with our life. That physics will be named as a biophysics. Then we have astrophysics. Astrophysics is considered with the study of astronomical bodies. And what are these astronomical bodies are? Simply all the bodies which have heavily masses, like our planets, solar system. All these things are related with the study of physics, which is named as a astrophysics. Then we have electronics, and this electronics is a branch of physics which deal with the study of development of electrical charges in which the motion of electron is controlled. All these are branches of physics. Now we are discussing about the importance of physics in our daily life. So what is the basic role of physics in our daily life? So physics play a vital role in our daily life. Whatever the luxuries we are using in our daily life, like we are using juicer machines, we are using air conditions, we are using refrigerators for traveling purpose, we are using different machines, different vehicles, like we are using motorbike, aeroplanes, cars, all these are run by an engine. And the engine of these all the vehicles are related with a branch of physics which was named as a thermodynamics. Nowadays we are listening or we are watching different live programs, like we are watching live telecast programs, we are watching live cricket on television. These are also all the application of solid state physics in our daily life. Now we have another term to discuss, that is a scientific method. And this, what is scientific method is, it is a simply a method which is used for the search of truth. It means ki for any truth, the method which is used is simply named as a scientific method. This scientific method is consist of different parts, which are few steps are given here. Number first is observation. This observation is simply creating of ideas, or simply we can define as the getting correct and maximum information about a problem, taking a number of observation. For thinking about anything, we just first of all observe. After that, we have a hypothesis, and a hypothesis is simply defined on the basis of information which is collected in observation. It is tested again and again. A scientific term hypothesis is used. Simply, hypothesis is what? A possible solution for the problems. Now, after experiment, if we have a possible solutions, or if we solve the problems, now we are simply experimenting them. After experimenting, if the results are come true, then it is able to write that written thing will be named as a theory. Then we have principle or simply law. When the theory is take through well-controlled experiments performed by different workers and found correct, then the term will be referred as principle or law. Now we have a teaching of Islam and science. As we know, we all are Muslim and we have believe in our holy book that is named as a Quran. So in Holy Quran, Allah Pak says about the knowledge is first revelation when Holy Prophet was in the cave of Hira. So what does that read? In the name of Lord who created man from cloud, read, it is the Lord the most beautiful who teach by pen teaching man which he did not know. So in these following verses, this surah was taken from ayat number 1 to 5. In this surah, Allah Pak says he created the man from mud. And although he made it very beautiful, when he was born, he did not know anything. So after that, the Quran says that the superiority of Adam to angel is due to the knowledge of things, and he taught Adam all the names. Now, the human beings have superiority in the angels regarding only the one difference, that is a knowledge. Now, from the Hadith Sharif, our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the first thing is gain the knowledge if you have had to travel even China. Number second is to gain the knowledge is obligation to every Muslim man and woman. Now we have a contribution of Muslim and Pakistani scientists. Here are the few roles of scientists, especially Muslim and Pakistani. Now the first one is Abu Ali Hassan ibn al-Haytham. He was born in Basra in 1965 AD at the city of Iraq. He died in Cairo in 1039 AD. Now here is a few discoveries about it. This great scientist work in the field of optics. So the main focus of Ibn al-Haytham was regarding the optics. His famous book that was written on the light, that is Kitab al-Manazir. He described the nature of light and proved that it is in a form of energy. He discovered the laws of reflection and explained process of reflection of light. He explained the formation of rainbow. He also invented a camera which was named as a pinhole camera, and that camera was used to obtain the image of sunscape. Now there is another scientist named as a Yaqub ibn Ishaq al-Kindi. So he was born in 800 AD in Basra. He was died in 873 AD. There is a few discoveries or few invention which was given by Yaqub ibn Ishaq. He was honored with a title that is the first earth philosopher. He did many research in metallurgy, specific gravity and curves. He explained the idea that gold cannot be made from other materials. He worked in the field of optics and explained music in scientific way. अबू अर रहमान इब्न मोहम्मद बिन अहमद अल बैरूनी. ही वाज बॉर्न इन 1973 एडी इन अ विलेज इन अ बैरून अफगानिस्तान एंड डाइड इन 1048. ही रोट मोर देन 150 बुक्स ऑन डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स सच एज मैथमेटिक्स, फिजिक्स, बायोलॉजी, जियोग्राफी, एस्ट्रोनॉमी, केमिस्ट्री, हिस्ट्री, कल्चर, सिविलाइजेशन एंड रिलेटेड रिलीजियस कस्टम. हिज फेमस बुक वॉज कानून अल मसूल. ही डिस्कस द मेरमेंट एंड मूवमेंट ऑफ अर्थ, फेज ऑफ मून एंड मूवमेंट ऑफ अदर प्लैनेट्स. ही गेव द मेथड ऑफ डिटरमाइनिंग द लॉन्गिट्यूड एंड लेटिट्यूड ऑफ अ प्लेस. ही डिटरमाइन द डेंसिटी ऑफ मेटल्स. ही मेजर द सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ अर्थ. नाउ वी हैव अ पाकिस्तानी साइंटिस्ट. Number first is Dr. Abdus Salam. He was a Pakistani scientist. Also, this Muslim scientist was born in Jhang, a small city in Punjab, in 1926. He received a Nobel Prize in 1979 for presenting a theory that was named as Grand Unification Theory. This Grand Unification Theory was interaction of electromagnetic and weak nuclear force. He established an international research institute of development countries in Italy. Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan. He was born in 1st April 1937 at Bhopal in India. He obtained his metallurgy degree from Holland and got PhD degree from University of Haven. From Holland, he returned to Pakistan in 1975. He started work in researching laboratory Islamabad, which later renamed as a Dr. A.K.U. Khan Research Laboratory. Due to his efforts, effective efforts, Pakistan has become seventh nuclear power in the world. He was awarded as Hilal-e-Imtiaz by the government of Pakistan. Thank you very much.
This is called Ben Shirley and I'm not.